virtual photo walks.
Good afternoon, everybody. We are here for another virtual photo walks event, and I would like to say hi from lovely Pittsburgh. It's very hot and humid today, and we are in front of the Duquesne Incline. Today, we're going to visit Duquesne Incline, which is an inclined plane railroad, or some people call it funicular, located here in Pittsburgh's Mount Washington. Mount Washington is one of the highest points of the city, and this incline was designed by Samuel D. Scher in 1877, and we are 800 feet high, which is 244 meters long, and then there is a 30 degrees angle, which I'm going to give a lot of details soon. There is one important information I would like to share today is that it's an unusual Russian gauge, and the rail gauge system is 5 feet broad gauge. So let's walk together inside the incline. This is one of the, I think, a couple of inclines standing and working in the country. So there were so many inclines here in Pittsburgh. But at the moment there are only two. So this is the main entrance of the Duquesne Incline, and if you ask me, people just use this. When it was first designed, it was basically to carry the cargo up to the mountain because people were tired of climbing the hill. But when it comes to, you know, carry their stuff, they just created a railroad system. And now people are still using this funicular for going down because there's a metro and, you know, bus station down there. And there is a nice cable car museum here. But before we go ahead, I'm just going to give you some information about where we are and how we're just going to go. And I would like to thank you to Port Authority for letting us to go to the machinery today. It's a surprise because I'm going to show you the machinery and how the, you know, this cart works. But just to give you an idea, if you can see here, there are two carts. One cart is coming up now, which we're going to be in minutes. So if I want to give you some more information about that, this was, again, I built in 1877. And as you can see, there is a 30 degrees angle. This cart can take up to 18 passengers. And while one cart is going up, the other one goes down. And when it was first designed, of course, the engine was working with a steam power. And as you think that Pittsburgh is a coal and steel, you know, capital of the nation, but then all the system is now working in by an electric motor. But the gear, the original gear, is exactly the same. It's the wooden teeth gear, which I'm going to show you. Before I go and start, I would like to give you some history about Pittsburgh too. This is basically a unique place for cable cars. And we have a nice, you know, table here. There are some other funiculars and cable cars all over the, you know, world. As you can see, it's from Hong Kong to New Zealand, from Turkey to Brazil. We have different, you know, cards of the, you know, pictures of the card system. So when we look at the incline was built in 1877, May 20th. And it opened for basically business, you know, to carry cargo. And then after some years, it just worked fine. But in early 90s, the incline was not working very well. And it was just, you know, people used to get their cars and horses. So incline was not working very well. And in 1964, a society, which is called the Duquesne Incline Society's build up, and they decided to, you know, renovate the incline and make it work again. And if you look at the history of the city, Pittsburgh is a coal and steel capital of the nation. And as you can see from here, it was a very, you know, dark and air pollution and old steel mills and coal mines. And up until 1970s, you know, Pittsburgh stayed as the coal and steel capital of the nation. But after 1970s, the steel industry just, you know, moved to China. And after that, all those coal mines and steel industry, you know, started to disappear. Pittsburgh is also a unique town with the number of bridges. There are 447 bridges in Pittsburgh. And if you look at the world, you know, records book, it's the number is more than the bridge number in Venice. So it's in the world record book, the highest number of bridges in the world is in Pittsburgh. We have 447 bridges. And as I see, steel is the main, you know, income and industry in Pittsburgh, and all World War I, World War II, even the steel for the Twin Towers, steel for the Brooklyn Bridge, and everything was supplied from the Pittsburgh. So before we're going to the missionary, I'm just going to take you out to the observation deck, and then we're going to go to the missionary, and we're going to take the card. Basically, Pittsburgh is a three-river city. There are two rivers intersecting, Allegheny and Monongahela rivers, and they are just joining and forming the Ohio River, and Ohio River goes down and connects to the Mississippi. So we are now on the observation deck, which is one of the best escape movies. I just want to check if I have a good view. So we are in the one of the highest points of the city. As you can see, the left one, the river on the left, is the Allegheny River. And as you can see, there are too many bridges. As I mentioned, it's the city of bridges. We have 447 bridges. It's more than Venice. So on the right-hand side, you can see the Monongahela River. And they just join here together, and they form the Ohio River. And Ohio River goes down to Mississippi. And as you can see there's a yellow stadium. It's called Heinz Field. It's the home of Steelers. If you have Steelers fans out there, yes, they play their game. And also this stadium may be a little bit familiar for you from the, you know, latest Batman movie, when the stadium was just, you know, demolishing. The Batman movie was, you know, formed and projected in Pittsburgh, so we have this movie, most of the parts were in from Heinz Field. And up there, if you can see, is the PNC Park. PNC Park is the home of Pittsburgh Pirates baseball team. And we call the tip of the triangle as the point. And point was also, there was a fort here, which was Fort Duquesne and Fort Pitt. It's also, Pittsburgh is historically one of the keystone states of the United States history. As you can see, we don't have any, you know, steel mines and, you know, steel mills and coal mines around here. Out of those, you know, dirty and polluted air, Pittsburgh formed a fantastic and one of the most livable cities of the country. And you can see downtown area here. There is a tall building which is called U.S. Steel Tower. It is the 14th highest, you know, building in the country. And next to it, there is the Bank New York Mellon building. And in between, you can see a Gothic glass building, which is PG building. And it's one of the remarkable buildings of the city, too.
Which is the Children's Hospital.
Children's Hospital is very far, you know, there is a big, you know, water twinkler there. It's very far, and it's a huge, you know, complex. It's a massive hospital. Yeah. And UPMC has a huge system in Pittsburgh, and there are so many hospitals here. And the Children's Hospital of Pittsburgh is up at the hill.
Perfect.
As you can see, still, you know, Costers are carrying coal, steel coal is one of the important industry here, and also the natural gas. So basically, I'm just gonna get a couple of pictures, and then I'm just gonna move to the machinery, and then I'm just gonna explain you how the gear works, and we're gonna get the cart, we're gonna go down, and we are 400 feet, you know, high from the bottom, and this is a cable car, you know, railroad. And I'm just gonna show you, this is a very historic building too. Just to give you an idea, this was, as I mentioned, designed as a, you know, cargo, you know, car, but then they started to, you know, carry the passengers, and believe it or not, it cost $47,000 to the, you know, people who lived around here, and it opened, as I mentioned, in May 20, 1877. And in 1962, a Duquesne Incline Lovers, you know, society just formed here. They just did a lot of fundraising to keep it. And this incline is open, you know, all year round. And you know how tough the winters are. Even when the snow is very hard, you know, this incline is working every single day. And we would like to thank to the preservation of the Duquesne Heights Incline Society and the Port Authority to keep this alive. Now we're gonna work together, walk together towards the missionary. We got a special permission approval to go there. They don't let everybody, you know, to go there. It's just a very good. And then before we go, I would like to give you some information. The gear is an original 12-foot drive gear, and there are 130 pairs of replaceable wooden gear teeth. So this is the only, you know, incline in the country that has a wooden gear teeth. And the
get it steady on that. Wow, that is cool.
So, as I mentioned, this was designed by Samuel Disher. Samuel Disher was born in 1839. He's an Hungarian. He was born in Budapest. And he studied engineering in Germany and then moved to Switzerland. And at age 27, he migrated to United States and settled in Ohio. And he just first did his first incline in Ohio State. And after moving here, he just saw this beautiful hill, and he decided to design another, you know, incline here. As you can see, it's a 130 wooden teeth. So those days, you know, only the main, you know, diameter was steel, but the gears were all wooden. And probably the car just reached the bottom station, and now it stopped. And as you can see, the hoist cables, safety cables, and there's a nice bearing table here, which just takes the, you know, steel cables. So basically, this is the machinery room of the Duquesne Incline. I just want to share, it smells like, you know, very metallic smell. It smells like steel and grease and oil in here. And I'm gonna give you some. Now the first ring means that the cart is ready. And the second bell is gonna say the doors are gonna be closed. Three is the safety, and the fourth, you know, bell means that they're gonna be on their way.
That is really impressive.
Okay, and I would like to show this this diagram to you too, and it shows how the system works here. I'm just gonna get closer. This is where we are, and they are just carrying the cable, and cables are hooked up to other two drums, and there are two big drums down there, and they're carrying the cable cars. So if I just give you a view, this is how the system mechanically works and design. It's a beautiful piece of art designed by Mr. Disher, Samuel Disher. And the second bell means doors are closing. Third bell, safety bell, and then fourth bell, now it's working. So again, it's now working, and the cart is going down. And as you can see, the cable is running here. Where's the drum? And then from that hole, it goes to the other drum, and the other drums change the direction, and then it moves the cart here. These are the other drums that I showed you on this picture.
So you kids in Buffalo can do all kinds of research and Google searches on these gears and the history of Pittsburgh.
More than that, we're going to get the cart in a minute. So our cart has arrived here, you see.
Oh, beautiful. That's a great shot. Well, I hope June's watching on YouTube, because June was in here and she wasn't feeling well, so I hope she is at least able to watch on YouTube today. You see her online, Jamie, at all?
Now we're waiting to get our cart, and we're going to get on the cart. While we wait, I'm just going to give you a little bit more information, technical information for our friends. The length of the track is 794 feet, and we are up at 400 feet high. And as you can see, there is an angle. The angle is 30.5 degrees, and the speed of the cart is 6 miles per hour, which is about, I believe, 8 and a half kilometers per hour. And the passenger capacity for car is 80 passengers. And then I'm just going to ask when we're going to get our car, and I'll be back.
Okay.
Okay, now the cart is ready for us, and we're getting in. We're slowly moving towards the car. Wooden car. Outside is still, as you can see, it just works. And the inside is, I'm going to just show you. There are seats here, and then from the window, you just can see the beautiful Pittsburgh. And I'm just going to give you some view from the inside of the car. This cable car is all wooden seats. They're almost, 200 years old. There's a fantastic lamp here. Now there's a light bulb, but I believe it was just candles before. Now the doors are closed, and we are on our way down. And then in the middle of the track, we're just going to meet with the other car. And as you can see, it's very steep.
No kidding. No kidding.
And we are just meeting with the other car. And then I'm just going to give you the opposite side view of the, you know, cables are on the other side.
You have people watching from Peru, Ergin.
Awesome. I am friends, and I hope they're enjoying the walk.
Long way away.
Okay, we're just getting off, and I'm going to give you another view of the car. And then we're going to pay for our ticket, and we're going to get the car, and we're going to climb back again. But before, I would like to give you a view from the, you know, window. This is basically from the level. You can see the point, and you can see the Heinz field, and we are at the bottom.
I wonder if this is ever used in any movie, any movies, Ergin.
This has been used in several movies. So the incline was featured in the opening scene of the Next 3 Days trailer. And the same scene is featured about halfway through the film. And Flashdance, 1983 movie, it was also featured in Flashdance. And in 1987 movie, Lady Beware, Diane Lane and her boyfriend, Cutter Smith, ride the incline. And also, Duquesne Incline is a featured Pittsburgh landmark on Instagram. So we're going to get the next car. And while we wait, I'm just going to mention a couple of names here. This is James Priskin. There was a Society for the Preservation of the Duquesne Heights Incline. This was for the memory of James Priskin. He worked for more than 30 years to preserve and maintain this missionary of this historic incline. And these are historic pictures from the Pittsburgh. This is the West Carson Street, which is this street, you know, down here. And also there's a railroad, cars are passing. This is West Carson Street. And this is from a picture from 1910 or 17. Uh-huh. And this building on the right-hand side is exactly where we are now. This is the incline's lower station. And then this is another historic picture from the West Carson Street. You can clearly see Indian Trail steps. So that's why they built up those incline to carry their cargo. And there's a gas light here, lower station where we are here right now. And as you can see, there was a light rail system throughout the city, and people were using here horses and wagons to carry it, but it's a very high, steep mountain hill, so people decided to build up something easy to carry their stuff. This is a historic landmark, Duquesne Incline, built in 1877. And there's a Pittsburgh History and Landmarks Foundation. And Pittsburgh is also one of the very unique cities that you can see this blue board almost in every building and everywhere. This is a quite historic place. And now our car is now approaching. And then before we go, I'm just going to show you where we're going to go. Let me just take this phone out of here. So this is where we're going to climb.
Oh, wow, that's a shot. That's impressive, Ergin. I could see a movie director having all kinds of fun with this.
Particular car, as you can see, is still in use 365 days, every single day. So as you can see, it's very, very steep. Start showing how we're going to climb from here.
Well, that's a really cool shot.
And if the speed is 6 miles per hour, and this car can take up to 18 passengers, and now on the halfway through, you're going to clearly see the other car is coming. Okay, now I'm going to show you the other side view. And now we are climbing again.
Wow, that is a shot.
And as you can see, it is the three rivers, Allegheny River, Monongahela River, and they're forming Ohio River. And there is a fountain up down there. It's called The Point, the tip of the, you know, of, downtown area. And again, I would like to mention all about these beautiful bridges. It's a city of bridges. There are 447 bridges in Pittsburgh, more than Venice.
More than Istanbul.
More than Istanbul, yes. More than anywhere I've been.
it's a beautiful
city. And now we're again going up to the 400 feet high. Thank you. And we are back to the upper station. And we are getting off.
What a great location. That just made for a virtual photo walk. Excellent.
This is one of the world-renowned and unique places, and thousands of people every year come and want to visit this, you know, incline. So I would like to say bye from where we started. I hope everybody enjoyed this walk, and it's a privilege for me to have a virtual photo walk with you once again. And I would like to thank you for being with us. And next time, I would like to meet you some other places from the world. And I would like to say bye. It was a great pleasure for me to be with you and walk through the Duquesne Incline together.
Okay, Ergin. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Bye-bye, everybody.
They're all waving. Bye.
I'm going to just. All right. Bye-bye, everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Ergin is a cardiothoracic surgeon from the UPMC Hospital in Pittsburgh and has volunteered many times to help virtual photo walks, and we thank him very much for that.
Virtual photo walks. Virtual photo walks.